Hi guys, we're here with B.Beat. Today we'll start to record some tutorials to explain to you roughly how this device works. A very simple device to use. The manual is very complete, exhaustive, and in any case, usually, the functions are at a self-learning level. So there is no problem in learning how to use B.Beat. The tutorials will explain a little about the operating logic of the machine, then go into detail. Of course, we advise you to download the manual that you can find on the B.Beat page on www.m-live.com in various languages. Let's start with the B.Beat operating logic. The B.Beat, as you know, plays backing tracks, up to 16 mono tracks, together with the audio part. Therefore, together with the audio backing tracks part, it can also play a video synchronized with the music. B.Beat can play also a MIDI format file that contains the various information that must circulate on stage to give messages or launch exclusive systems to the several devices we use for our performance. So, audio, video, and MIDI. These are the main file formats that can be used with B.Beat. Obviously, at the audio file level, the formats are the most varied. We can go from a simple stereo MP3 to a WAVE format file, or to all the other types of audio files, with different formats that are available today. Otherwise, we have multi-track files where there are separate tracks, which therefore can be managed with the B.Beat with maximum freedom. Each of these tracks can be mixed as you wish. Here are the 6 separate outputs, which can route the various audio channels to the room mixer. What we want to focus on today is the computer connection. Why the computer connection? Because one of the main ways to transfer audio, video, and MIDI material within B.Beat is achieved through the use of the computer. Because logically your audio tracks will be loaded and stored, they will also normally be built on a computer. How do we go through these steps? First of all, how does B.Beat connect to the computer? There are several ways, the easiest being to connect it directly with the supplied cable. It is a network cable connected directly to the PC, when the computer has the network input. Most of the time, this network input is present. Otherwise, we can use a hub that could also be a modem, or in any case, a switch that allows us to manage the network inside your home, inside your studio, and in this case, we use this network hub. Insert the cable in the B.Beat panel. And in this moment, the B.Beat is connected to our computer. The other way to connect the B.Beat is to use the Wi-Fi pen, which is an option of B.Beat. An option provided by M.Live named M.Pen, which fits into the dedicated slot on the right panel of the B.Beat. Through the Wi-Fi pen, we can connect to the home Wi-Fi network or directly to the PC. These different methods allow some flexibility for the transfer of data between B.Beat and the computer. One of the main parts of B.Beat is its matching software, the B.Beat Manager. It runs on both PC and Mac. Here we have loaded the first screen. When we connect our B.Beat to the computer hosting the software, the computer will find the connected B.Beat on the network. The B.Beat has been detected, and at this point we can connect with the software. As you can see, in this case, I have the visualization of the audio projects that are present inside the B.Beat. Using this mode, the B.Beat basically becomes a passive device, so it is totally controlled by the computer. And all the operations I'm going to do, from this moment on, the computer will be directly transferred to the B.Beat. So, if I look for audio projects, if I start a playlist, if I organize a show, any operation I do within the software is directly transferred to the B.Beat. So, summarizing this first part relating to the connections, we can connect the B.Beat via network cable directly to the computer or via a hub, or through the Wi-Fi network using this pen, which is an accessory available in the M-Live catalog. It is called the M-Pen, which can be used on various live products and also on the B.Beat. This pen connects to the network, so it allows you to do this exchange. Obviously, if you need to transfer a large archive with lots of gigabytes of memory, the cable connection is much faster than the pen. However, the transfer operation can also be done easily with the pen. In the next tutorial, we will see how files can be managed and how files are transferred from the computer directly into B.Beat. So far, thank you, and greetings from M-Live.